morning. I'm Erin Fehlau. This is News 9 Plus on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. And these are some of the stories that we're following for you today. Stratford County Sheriff Mark Brave is planning to go on administrative leave starting today. Stratford County commissioners met yesterday and demanded that Brave accept a paid leave of absence or they would petition for his removal. Now, this comes after the attorney general says that Brave stole $19,000 in county funds. Brave denies the allegations, saying the case is politically and racially motivated.
The county, the attorney general, has found no signs of racism during their investigation. I know some of that's been pointed directly towards me. I can only say this, that this has nothing to do with the color of his skin, but the content of his character.
Commissioners say Brave's bail terms include no contact orders with nearly all of the sheriff's department staff, making it impossible for him to perform his job while his criminal case is pending. News 9 has reached out to Brave for comment, but we have not yet heard back. A 19-year-old from Henniker is dead after a police chase ended in a wild crash near Springfield, Massachusetts. A trooper tried to pull the driver over last night, but he took off. The unidentified driver allegedly ran a red light and went off the road. He was thrown from the car along with the engine, which went right into a brick house. Look at this. The debris even reached the second floor. The driver was pronounced dead at the scene. It is going to be a beautiful day outside today, getting off to a great start there in Plymouth right now. A lot of sunshine, Matt, and what's in store for the rest of the day?
Yeah, dry, comfortable, and mostly sunny, Erin. Looks like a great day of weather here as high pressure is building in across the state today. Nice morning out there. Very comfortable with readings in the 50s and 60s. Now, our readings will be seasonably cool for this time of year. Normal high sits right around 80 degrees or so, and it'll be a struggle to get there in the next couple of days, but still a pretty pleasant stretch of August weather, all things considered. Still in the low 50s up in Berlin and Whitefield this morning, 56 degrees in Keene, but we've now jumped into the mid 60s along the seacoast and in Manchester. A lot of heat building off to our west, but that largely stays at bay. That means we'll stay on the seasonable side of things here through mid to late week. In Concord, we're heading for the upper 70s this afternoon with a good amount of sunshine and a freshening northwesterly breeze. It's dry today and tomorrow before our next system moves in here for late week with some rain chances by later Thursday. It will be chilly up north tonight. We likely get back into the lower 40s early tomorrow morning through the north country, upper 40s to low 50s elsewhere. But full sunshine tomorrow warms us back into the mid and upper 70s. Thursday, it's a dry start to the day, then clouds thicken up during the afternoon, along with the chance for a few scattered showers and an even better chance of rain on the way for Friday. Until those rain chances arrive, the pollen count staying very high this time of year. Of course, ragweed is the big allergen. By late week, we cool things down a little bit along with more clouds. Shower and thunderstorm chances make a return late Thursday and Friday. But the good news is I'm optimistic that by the weekend, we'll start to clear things out. It's not all that warm. We're still in the 70s, but at least we should see the return of some sunshine and a nice weekend at this point to get outdoors.
We're seeing a lot of sunshine out here in Manchester, but if you can watch this shot here, it's kind of bouncing around out there. We do have some very breezy air out there.
Yeah, you know, today's one of those days where you dip in the pool, Erin, you come out and you're cold immediately because it's dry. And yeah, that wind also making things feel a little bit cooler than what it actually is.
All right. Okay. Yeah. Thanks, Matt. Appreciate it. Moving on this morning, Fish and Game officials are warning hikers to be prepared for the colder conditions in the mountains. Over the weekend, conservation officers conducted 3 rescues for hypothermia. They say another person died because of the colder conditions in the mountains this summer. One colonel says that hikers are dressing for the base temperatures, but not for temperatures at the top. And according to the Mount Washington Observatory, the temperature on the summit right now is just 40 degrees. So there is a difference between the base temp and the summit temp. Well, the state attorney general's office is adding 3 new jobs focused on helping older adults avoid common scams. A new prosecutor, law enforcement investigator, and investigative paralegal will join the Elder Abuse and Financial Exploitation Unit. They say that there has been a 71% increase over the last 5 years in elders who say that they've been exploited by caregivers or financial advisors.
Most of the scams that we see are money related. You've probably heard of them, the IRS scam, grandparent scam. So an IRS scam, for instance, where a scammer calls you up and says that they're going to come and arrest you because you have unpaid IRS taxes.
They often use scare tactics, and the Attorney General's office says that more than 37,000 older adults in New Hampshire fall victim to scams every year. Well, thank you for joining us for News 9 Plus here on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. We hope you have a great day.